Okay, hey everybody, got another something for you that's made in America. I needed a saw and I went to Home Depot and just wanted something inexpensive. This saw right here, which is the 15-inch tool box saw, just a regular old good old everyday saw, was it was like $9.95. And the best thing about it, now look over there, can you see where it says guaranteed? Forever! Okay, and the best thing about it, dun, 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 made in the USA with domestic and foreign components, but it's made in the USA. It's assembled here, it's put together here with domestic and foreign components. So go to the store, buy a saw, Husky brand, and enjoy things made in America. Hey guys and dolls, just another thing about living on less, and as a single parent, you know, I'm on an extremely limited budget. So we just had the holidays, as you know, and so in my store, my HEB, and I'm sure in any grocery store is going to have the same stuff, they have, you know, specialty items for the holidays and things like that, you know, are kind of pricey or whatever. So after the holidays, I always, or just all the time, I always check their little clearance areas. And here's some stuff I picked up. I picked up, you know, some quick breads in different flavors. This is a pumpkin one, banana, gingerbread. And these were 75 cents each. And then this one, I think, was like 80 something cents. I don't know why this one was more, but. And then this is the Celestial Seasonings tea that they only have out during the holiday. See, it says holiday tea. This one is the gingerbread spice, and this one is the sugar plum spice. I've had the gingerbread one before, and it's very delicious. And then I'm going to try this one. I haven't ever had this one before. But I think these were like a dollar each. I can't find the sticker on them, and I don't know what I've done with my receipt on it. But I think they were like a buck each. And right now, I'm cooking one of these in pumpkin. I had another one, a Pillsbury, that was also 75 cents. And it's actually in the oven right now. I don't know if you can see it. See it cooking? It's right back there. So it's going to be delicious, I'm sure. But, you know, this stuff, this will last us. I try to do a sweet every week. I haven't been too good on that lately. But, you know, this will last for a month right there. And it's 75 cents. And then all you have to add to it usually is something like water. This one has water, oil, and eggs. So, you know, it's very easy to do. So make sure you check your clearance areas at your stores. A lot of times it's not bad food or outdated food. It's just food that they don't have room for. It's just like clothing in a mall. You know, at the end of the season, they got to get rid of it to make room for other stuff. So think about that on your next trip. Some more stuff about living on less and buying American made and things like that. I had a gift certificate that I had gotten at Christmas time, and I needed some socks. And so I was in this department store. And they had some socks on clearance, and I had grabbed some and realized that one pair was made in America and the other two were made in China. So I put the other two back and got more of the ones that were made in America. So I wanted to share it with you and also, you know, about the discount and stuff. So these are Hue. This is HUE. You can't really see it through this little proof of purchase thingy, but they're Hue brand socks, okay? And they have all different kinds, and these are nice, good, thick, you know, for what am I trying to say? For warmer, excuse me, for colder weather. The other pair's in the dirty clothes, so I did get three pairs. But anyway, what I'm trying to show you, if I can get this thing whipped around here, is that, whoop, wrong way, is they were $3.90 a pair, regularly $6.50. And if you look, right here, made in USA of domestic and imported yarn. So the yarn, okay, may be from somewhere else, but it's made here in d of domestic and imported yarn. So to me, two-thirds of these at least is made in America, if not more, because if they used all American yarns, then there you go. So just to let you know, again, Hue brand socks made in America, but always look at the label because you never know if they're going to change it at some point. But here you go, Hue brand socks. They're wonderful. They're lovely. They're cottony soft and very good, very inexpensive, and go just in your normal department stores. So there you go, living on less, made in America. Get real, people. Many, many years of not having a mop. Literally, yes, I've been getting on my hands and knees to mop. I went to the store and I got a mop today. And guess what? I'm going to get it really close because you can't see it. Ha, ha, ha. It's made in the USA. And guess what else came with it? It's a spray mop. It's one of those that has the little tank thingy on it. And it came with an extra deal. And see, there's the little thingy right there. Made in the USA. And I got it at Target. And it was $20. And they had other ones there that were similar. And like, this is washable. This little pad thingy comes off. It's washable, so you don't have all those, you know, throwaway thingies that don't work. And they had other brands there. Like, they had the O-Cedar that I thought was American made. And it's not. It's not. It's not. It's not. It's not. And so I got this one made in the USA. Okay, I'm done.